Welcome all. In the last video, we have started our unit number 2, network theorem. The first point we have covered is the superposition theorem. Before that, we have seen the linearity property. According to linearity property, it satisfies homogeneity and additivity. So this is the statement of superposition theorem. So it is applicable only for linear circuit. Superposition theorem is used only for the linear circuit. Non-linear circuits, if there is a non-linear circuit, we cannot use superposition theorem. Then, with the help of superposition theorem, what we are doing? We are calculating voltage across or current through any element. So, whenever we are using superposition theorem, we have to consider few cases. So, as there are two sources, so we will consider two cases. So, in case number one, this 3 volt source is present and this 0.25 ampere source is turn off. Turn off means it is a current source, means turn off meaning is it is open circuit. And second case, this 0.25 ampere current source is present and this 3 volt source is turn off. So if it is a voltage source, turn off meaning is that it is replaced by a short circuit. Then initially current is I1, then second case current is I2. Then total current I is nothing but the algebraic sum, I1 plus I2. So this way we have to use the superposition theorem. So before going for the numerical, let's see few notes. So number one, if voltage source is turned off, means it is replaced by a short circuit. Because turn off, voltage source is turned off means 0 volt, and 0 volt meaning is short circuit. If current source is turned off, if current source is turned off, means current value is 0 ampere, so it is nothing but open circuit. Then only, if it is open circuit, then only we get the 0 ampere current. So case 1, voltage source is turned off means it is replaced by short circuit. If current source is turned off means it is replaced by an open circuit. And if there are any dependent sources, then dependent source is intact in the circuit. That means we will keep as it is. We will not make short circuit or open circuit to the dependent sources. As you know that independent sources are represented by a circle and dependent sources are represented by a diamond shape. So if there is any dependent voltage source or dependent current source, we will keep it intact in the circuit. We will not replace it by the short circuit or open circuit. So dependent source is never replaced by short circuit or open circuit while using superposition theorem. I hope it is clear. Okay, let's consider first example. So using superposition theorem, find V0 in the given circuit. Okay, so where is V0? Okay, so V0 is the voltage across this 2 ohm resistor. We have to calculate it using superposition theorem. So there are two sources. How many cases we have to consider? We have to consider two cases. Case number one, this 12 volt source is present. Then what about this 5 ampere source? It is turn off. Turn off meaning is it is current source is turn off means it is replaced by an open circuit. So we will remove this 5 ampere branch. We will remove this branch. And in case number 2, consider this 5 ampere source is present. Then what about this 12 volt source? It is turn off. Turn off means it is voltage source is turn off means it is replaced by a short circuit. Okay. So let's see in case 1 how your circuit will look like. So case 1, consider 12 volt source is present. Then this 5 ampere source is turn off. Turn off means it is replaced by an open circuit. So that's why I have removed that circuit. That's why I have removed that branch, not circuit. Okay. So this is the my simplified circuit in case number 1. So there are 2-3 methods to calculate this VO1 value. One method is you can consider current I here. Then you can use the KVL. So 12 minus 5I minus 3I minus 2I equal to 0, you will get the value of current. Then VO1 is nothing but that current into resistance, you will get the value of U1. That is one method. But if you want to get the answer in shortest amount of time, you can see that this 12 volt source is in series with this 5 ohm, 3 ohm and 2 ohm. You can use voltage division rule. So according to voltage division rule, V01 is same resistance means voltage across this 2 ohm resistance, so same resistance 2 divided by total resistance 2 plus 3 plus 5, 10 divided by 2 divided by 10 into total value of voltage. 12 total value of voltage is 12 volt. Okay, so police are doing patrolling. So 2 divided by 10 into 12. So the answer is 24 divided by 10 is 2.4 volt. 0.4 volt is the value of V01. Now, so with the help of voltage division rule, we have easily got the value of V01. Now, case number 2, consider this 5 ampere source is present and this 12 volt source is short circuit. Okay. So, just remember V01 value is 2.4 volt. Then I will calculate V02. So, V02. Okay, now these 3 ohm and 2 ohm are in series, so total resistance is 5 ohm, because whatever current is flowing here, the same current is flowing through this 2 ohm resistance also, that's why these 3 ohm and 2 ohm are in series. Then 3 plus 2 is 5 ohm and this is one more 5 ohm resistance. So what is your observation about this 5 ohm resistance and this 5 ohm resistance? Again, there are various approaches to calculate the VO2 value, but I want that here, if you look at the circuit, you can easily observe few of the things. So what about this 5 ohm resistor and this 5 ohm resistor? How they are connected? Okay. So this is the node. So this node is shared by this 5 ohm resistor as well as by this 5 ohm resistor. And there is one more node. Here is this node. And this node is shared by this 5 ohm resistor. This node is shared by this 5 ohm resistor and this 5 ohm resistor. So whenever resistance shares two nodes, that means these resistances are connected in parallel, as you have seen. So this is one resistor, this is one resistor. They are sharing same two nodes, then they are connected in parallel. So similarly, this 5 ohm resistor and this 5 ohm resistor are in parallel. Okay. Now, so with the help of current division rule, I will calculate, because current source and parallel resistances are there, I can use the current division rule. So consider here current is I double dash. So what is the value of I double dash with the help of current division rule? Opposite branch resistance, that means this 5 ohm resistance, divided by total resistance. Total resistance is 5 plus 5, 10, into current source value is 5. So 5 into 5 25, 25 divided by 10, its value is 2.5 ampere. So I double dash value is 2.5 ampere. Same, this I double dash is flowing through this 2 ohm resistor. So what is the value of voltage? Current is 2 ampere, resistance is 2. So according to Ohm's law, V02 equal to I into R, V02 equal to I into R. So 2 into 2.5, 5 volt, and V01 is 2.4 volt. So total voltage is the algebraic sum. So total voltage is 2.4 volt plus 5 volt. So my answer is, final answer for VO is 7.4 volt is my final answer. Okay. So once again, I will repeat in short. So this circuit was given, we have to calculate this voltage. So I have considered this source is present, this source is turned off, means current source is open circuit. Then in case number 2, I have considered this 5 ampere source is present and this source is turned off, voltage source is turned off, means short circuit. And I have calculated VO1 value and VO2 value. Then after that, I have done the algebraic. You can use other methods also to calculate VO1 and VO2 with with the help of network analysis. Okay, thank you.